Now, First Alert Weather with meteorologist Tyler Jankowski.
With few exceptions, this winter has been pretty quiet for the last month and a half, but that is about to change as we go through the next couple days, but especially this weekend. Tomorrow we'll have a few snow squalls on the leading edge of some colder air. For many of us, that won't be significant. And then there'll be some light snow Friday morning, but we're not talking about much then. It's Saturday night and Sunday when there will be a more substantial storm that comes through the region. So a quick check in Montpelier shows clouds, temperature 18 with not much wind. Can also take a look at Grafton County, New Hampshire. This is looking over Plymouth, where it is warmer at 27. And again, on Storm Tracker, some flurries every now and again, but that's just about it. That's what we thought would happen. We're not tracking any big areas of snow as we go through the rest of today. And it's not quite as cold as the last couple days either. We have 21 in Burlington, 30 in Keene, and 21 in Saranac Lake. So highs today generally in the 20s to about 30 degrees as the flurries continue. Check out tomorrow. We're talking 30s. Tomorrow's actually the warmest day for quite a while, but that comes to an end with the snow squalls tomorrow afternoon. Some colder air comes in. In fact, check out the wind gust potential midday. This is lunchtime tomorrow. Over 30 miles per hour as the band of snow squalls comes through, and with temperatures right around freezing, it's possible that some roads become slippery pretty quickly as this band of snow comes through tomorrow. Not a lot of accumulation, but all the slipperiness, as you know, is in the first inch or covering, and that is a potential for tomorrow afternoon. So if you're doing any traveling, keep that in mind. Thursday looks good. Shouldn't even be much wind on Thursday. It'll be cold, but I think it'll be a good ski day with a lot of sun. And then on Friday morning, there's a round of light snow on the order of 1 to 3 inches. We'll show you the Friday morning map. So I would plan on a slippery commute for Friday morning, but again, that's minor. This is the big deal this weekend. It looks like the snow will come in late on Saturday evening, and then it really picks up Saturday night. Now, the trend with this storm has been west, but we've always been on the colder side, and it looks real cold on the cold side of this storm. So there will be some fluctuation in the track, but I'm growing more confident that the storm is going to hit us, and especially northern parts of the viewing area will have quite a lot of snow as we go through Sunday. It should be heavy at times. I think the bigger question that's starting to develop is how far north does the mix line get? So if you're watching in southern Vermont, maybe even up to the upper valley, there may be a mix in play, perhaps even some rain at some point in the middle of the storm on Sunday. But at this point, it looks like the farther north you are, the better the chance it'll be all snow. And it looks like a big storm for Saturday night into Sunday. So that's definitely the big thing on our radar, if you will, as we go forward. Here's the 5-day forecast. The snow squalls tomorrow, 32. Some sun there, actually a lot of sun on Thursday, but that's the colder day after the front goes through. Again, the round of light snow Friday morning, and then the bigger system comes in later Saturday and through much of Sunday. So we'll have our eyes on it with an update at 5. Dave?